wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals. I'm breaking in, shaping up, then checking out on the prison bus. This is it, the apocalypse. Whoa, I'm waking up, I feel it in my bones. Enough to make my system flow. Welcome to the new age, to the new age. Welcome to the new age, to the new age.
Welcome to the Fearless Center podcast. My name is Courtney, and you can also find me on Ravelry and Plurk, and now on Instagram. I don't know if I just said that. Today is May 5th, 2013, and this is episode 25. This is my second take because Sedona is being crazy. So, she might still be a little bit crazy. I don't know what she's doing. Alright, this is like the Maryland Cheaper Mall recap episode. I'm a little tired and sore, so if this doesn't seem like I'm excited or happy, I'm just tired. As you can see, I got sunburned pretty bad. You see the white lines? That's where my hair was down. It's lovely. My shoulders, oh, they hurt. So burned. I was offered sunscreen plenty of times. I declined it because I don't burn easy. My arms are already tan. They were a little red. And my hands are. I didn't even feel like, I can usually feel the sun on my face or something like, oh, okay, I'm getting burned. I didn't even feel that until I got in the car to drive back and I itched my shoulder. I was like, oh, what the world? And then my face started hurting. It's like, oh no. But it should be turning into a tan. Hopefully by tomorrow because I'm pretty red. It doesn't come over as red. It's redder. Anyway, so yesterday I got up bright and early and drove the 2 hours up. It only took me 1 hour and 40 minutes actually, which is unheard of because I go through DC. I mean, I take the beltway, like here's DC and I do this, but still there's usually a lot of traffic no matter what time of day. And there was a lot more cars than I expected at 6 o'clock in the morning, but nothing too bad. On my drive back, I got in a little bit of a, once I got onto the beltway, I didn't even get, turning onto the beltway was bumper to bumper, getting on the beltway was bumper to bumper. I was so frustrated. I'm like, oh my God, it's going to take me 6 hours to get home if this is like this all the way. It was about 5 minutes like that. It wasn't all that bad because there was a 6-car pileup. I counted the cars as I passed them. It was 6. At least, I believe it was 6. Right after that, it sped back up. And I didn't slow down ever again. So that was a 2-hour drive back. So when we first, I got there first at 7:40. My friends, Leslie Pixie Nuts from the Knitting Game podcast, and my friend Pam, Miss Purple, they, and Pam had two friends that came too. They got there yesterday, not yesterday, they got there Friday, and they left today. And so I was waiting for them. They didn't get there till 8. I was early. The one coming from Virginia was early. And then we walked around a little bit in the barns. Everything was still closed. We kind of got an idea where stuff was. And then we booked it for the main hall for Into the World. And Into the World was in the same spot. So it didn't take us too long to find them. And I grabbed At first, I didn't want to grab what I wanted because they were like, we can't check you out till 9. And it was like 8:30. But then it got really crowded. Like, I was in a corner like this. And I looked at the bats. I wanted Captain Taipan bat. That's what I got there for. And they only had three that I saw. So I was like, I started seeing people grabbing stuff and holding onto it. So I held onto it. And I might have got it. Still seen enabling. But as I was checking out, I saw Laura, Lala from the Knit Girl. So I talked to her for like 2 minutes. Then we did some more shopping and walking around, and I got stopped by CC Carrie, who recognized me from my podcast. So, hi, Carrie. That was the first and only person that recognized me from my podcast, but that was really nice. And then I also saw Laura again. Awful, there's so many people. I saw her again. And then I was waiting. Emily, who Fancy Pants from Watches Watching podcast, she couldn't make it to the podcaster meetup, so beforehand we messaged and set up a time to meet. And I was waiting for her. I saw Leslie, You Don't Call Me Les, from the Knit Girls podcast, and saw her son Colby. And Colby, did I just add an L? Okay, I met her son. Sorry. And then I met Emily, who I just said this, who Fancy Pants is from Watches Watching, and she's really sweet and just as adorable as on a podcast. And then we did some more shopping, and then was the podcaster meetup where I met all the podcasters that I wanted to, and almost all of them I watch all of them except for one, and it's almost all the podcasters that I watch. The only podcasters I didn't meet that I watch is Steve from Dramatic Knits and oh my god, I can't think of her name. I can think of her Ravelry name, not her real name. Dawn. Dawn from Wolf Farms. I could just think of Knitting Wolf. I could not get the name out. Anyways, as I said, I watch met all the podcasts I watch. So I first met, there was a circle of people knitting. And as I first woke up, I was like, oh, they're not podcasters, they're just here for a podcaster meetup. So I went to Hobbly Hoy and I heard a laugh. And that was an audio podcaster. And I was like, I know who that is. So I didn't know how she looked like. Like, we're friends on Plurk, but I don't just creepily look at people's pictures. So I walk over and I just go, Dana? And whoever looked at me, I was like, that's Dana. So I met Dana, who's Crafty Girl 83, and Brittany down the lane from the Just One More Rope podcast. And now I have crumbs in my throat from just eating. And then in the same circle, I saw Lisa from Fibronymph, who's the dyer from Fibronymph Yarns and the podcast 90% Knitting. Then Laura, Lala, and Leslie, You Don't Call Me Les, from the Knit Girls showed up. Then I saw Amy, who I look really forward to meeting her. I've been watching that podcast forever, and Darren wasn't there. But I feel like if they lived in my area, me and my fiance would be best friends with them. Sounds really creepy because I only met her once, but she's, I think, in my age group. And, like, we have similar personalities from what I can tell from watching her podcast, like clumsiness. And we everything she knits, I want to knit, like, is in my queue. And I just think she's adorable. So I met her. If I didn't even say, I'm sorry, I'm so discombobulated with so much information in my head. And I'm trying to get it out. All right, Amy Froggy Monkey from Knitting in Circles. I don't think I mentioned her podcast. So I got to meet her. And then Diane from Knittables. She recognized me. Like, not recognized. I met her last year. And she was just like, Courtney! And like gave me this huge hug. And that. She meets so many people. She knew my name. She didn't call me Stitches, please. She said, Courtney. I was like, oh my God. So. And she said how adorable I am. Just so you guys know. So. Anyways, it was so nice to see Diane again. I also met Laura and Leslie last year, just so you know. Everyone else was the first time I met them. And then I saw Kelly, who's Cheap Dreamery, who has the Diet from Cheap Dreamery and the Cheap Dreamery podcast. I'm sorry, Kelly, I don't watch your podcast yet, but I won yarn from her. So I was like, I have to say hi to her. So not that I have to, I wanted to. Sorry, that came out wrong. All right, that's all the people I met. And then enabling, that's what you want to stick around for, right? All right, whoops. I actually got some knitting done. My first is in my Pam Made My Bag. It's purple. It was cool. I got a compliment for it, and I'm like, she made it. So this project is way too big to be in this bag, but I just put my carabiner from my bird leg bag on here and latched it to my purse so I could be knitting. I barely knitted. I knitted one row. It's the My Hope shawl from Laura, who's a lot of Knitted Girls. And she knit on this, so I don't know how many stitches, but she knit on it. Where's the stitch marker thingy? This one. All right, it's still very cramped on the needles. I have two more rows of garter, and then I'll do a cable row. Here is, that's how much I did. Two rows. She knitted around this much, right at the spot too. So. Very nice, and I'm knitting that out of Creatively Dyed Yarns Calypso Queen Bays in the Lita colorway on US 5. Oh, and I have a bunch of yarn barf that just fell out. I can't show you the yarn ball, it's falling apart. But US 5 3.75 millimeter needles. Okay, put that back. And then, sorry, there's gonna be a lot of reaching. Everything is down in my bucket, right? Below me. And then next thing I knit around is in my tortoise bag, bird leg bag, that's missing the carabiner at the moment. And that is my Jerry the Musical Monkey by Rebecca Danger. I don't even know what I had done last time. Did I have a foot done? Well, I'm knitting that out of Plymouth Yarn Dream Baby DK out of some beige and brown, and I have, let me just tell you what I have done. First I finished the body, that's the body, then I finished an arm, and another arm, and two ears, and now I have two legs. I think one leg wasn't done. And now I have the tail on the needle. So I'm knitting that on my higher sharps, US 3, 3.25 millimeters. So stitch markers just to tell me the right side. Let me put back all this back in here. So I just have left the tail and the mouth, and then it's assembly time. And my goal is to finish that by the time my sister gets here. And then I know it's something I haven't knitted on in probably 5 months. That's also in a bird leg bags. It's in my monster bag. It's the cute little monster pole thingy bead. And then it's on my Pembroke vest by Kirsten Kapoor, which is out of Barocco Vintage in the Violetta color, number 5178. On US 7 4.5 millimeter needles. Mostly I've knitted on this because the needles were used on my flowers. I had finished the back last time you saw this. It's lots of cables. So I just played with my camera to see about my autofocus because I've enabling to show you and I want to see how the labels and everything. My camera doesn't have autofocus. So I need to get a camera that has autofocus, I guess. But I looked at some of them and I don't have my pen. Oh my god. Hold on. I got. Alright. Sorry, there was maybe an awkward pause. Boogie decided to puke right behind me. I couldn't even get up. I had to wait for my fiance to clean it. Because it was right behind my chair. I would have rolled my chair right into it. And he had a hairball. So yeah, I'm back. All right, let's see if I can finish this podcast eventually. First, Sedona jumps into the litter box and pretends like she's going to use the litter box. So I restarted that, and then Boogie pukes. So I don't know where I was or how I'm going to edit this. So I'm going to maybe repeat myself. Sorry. I'm knitting the Pembroke Vest by Kirsten Kapoor out of Barocco Vintage in the Violetta colorway, number 5178, on US 7, 4.5 millimeter needles. I had the back done. You can see the cables. And I'm on the front. And I've said it before, I don't know if I'm going to run out of yarn. It's possible. But I'm just knitting it, so I guess I run out. Oh yeah, right now I have nothing on the... I was like, there's no yarn attached. Duh. I'm at the front. And I don't know how far I was last time you saw it. I was maybe here. Maybe. But it has a V-neck, so at one point these stitches went on this holder, and I finished this part, and now they're back on the needles, and I did a reverse of this. So this is going really quick. But same cable as the back. All right, that's it for my whips. Honestly, I had no FOs. I didn't even mention that, but I have spinning, but I didn't take it off the wheel because I started this morning and I maybe spun for half an hour. So it's nothing enough to show you, but I show you the fiber. You've seen it before. It's crinkling. I won this in a contest. It's the first draft and I got to pick the base and color. It's Rambouillet and the color is quite contrary. And it's pinks with greens and pinks, and there's more green. I decided, because last time I showed this to you, I asked you how I should spin this. Well, I decided that I was going to spin the green on one bobbin and then the pink on another bobbin and ply them together. So right now, I'm spinning the first green. And this is coming out way more muted than it is. The pink is spot on, the green is highlighter green. It is bright. Alright. You ready for enabling? Keep in mind, my enabling is not that much. I mean, I'm happy with my purchases. I love them all. But I am on a wedding budget. And last year, my budget was twice as much. And I take cash. And once the cash is gone, it's gone. Last year that was true. This year, not so much. I went over on my credit card. Anyways, not by much. Not by a lot at all. But anyways, let's get to the fun stuff. First stop, as I said, was Into the World, more crinkling, to get a bat. And I did. I got Into the World, Falkland carded bat, and Captain Tight Pants. Yep. I'm not a Firefly fan, and I know this was a Firefly inspired colorway. I never watched Firefly, so it's not that I'm not a Firefly fan, I just haven't watched it. I'm sure I'd like it because I heard if you like Doctor Who, you like this. But when I saw the colorway for the club, oh my god. I mean, look at this. I needed it. I knew I needed this. And, I mean, it has. This is teal, to light blues, to yellow, into red, into brown. I've never spun a bat. So this will be my first bat. Chris is amazing. I told her how amazing she is. I told her how awesome her fiber is. That I used to be in her club and the reason why I got out. And that I love her prep. It's the best prep ever. It is. And I was like, well, I wanted to give a try a bat. And I was like, which better than yours? And she sold out by the time we went, the second time we got around. And they said they brought twice the amount of bats that they did last year. So that was the first purchase. After that, my friend Pam wanted to buy some from his bats. They were the four. I don't know how long she was in line. She was in line at least 20 minutes because Into the World might have broke the rules. They had like a lot of people in the booth begging them. Like I was fine just waiting. There was one person who kind of was, I don't know, she was like, I have other purchases to make, other lines to be standing in. Why are you gonna wait till 9? And wasn't dumb. It was not Chris and James, it was the festival. So finally James was like, let's just do it. And he's like, seen other people do it. So yeah, then I check out early. So Miss Babs didn't. And so we had to wait in line at least 20 minutes, and then the line started moving. By the time there was only three people in front of Pam, Leslie said, oh, I really like this year's colorway. And I was like, this year's colorway? Yeah, Miss Babs colors every Maryland unique colorway. And I was like, oh, I didn't know that. What? He just jumped on me. Say hello. Hey, puker. You feeling better? You better? Hairball gone? Once you tell me, my whole thing was I'm gonna buy stuff that I cannot get online or impulse. But big one was if I find something that I know I cannot get online, I want to get it. And that's why I got the bat form Into the World. That color, sorry, he choked the table. The color is difficult to get on the stash or anything, and it's a bat. Bats are difficult to get. And the next thing, sorry, I'm reaching. Oh, where did it go? It's all the way at the bottom, of course. So, Miss Babs was there. I talked to her for a little bit. I've never used Miss Babs. That was another thing. If I don't have it in my stash, I can get it. I don't have any bats. I don't have any Into the World bats. I have a loot bat, but that's a different kind of bat. And I have never used Miss Babs, and I don't have any Miss Babs. So this is her Maryland 2003. Yes, it's 2003, 2013 colorway. And it's Yummy Base hand painted fingering yarn 2-ply superwash. It's 100% merino, 400 yards. Enough for two of most socks. Isn't this pretty? It is pink with light pinks with pops of purple and pops of green. So, and Maryland 2013. Boogie, are you leaving? He's like half hanging off. But yes, that was my second purchase. Funny thing was, neither Pam or Leslie had one, so I had to grab three. Apparently, they had one with Sparkle, but I literally had to hurry because there's only like three or two people. There are two registers, and I think Pam was like next. So I had to like really hurry because I didn't want to look like I cut in front of everybody. I waited in line the whole time. It's not like I left and came back. So then the next purchase, I didn't actually purchase. This was gifted to me. I really wanted some socks that rocks. Sock that rock from Blue Moon. Because I've never seen it in person, I've never owned any, of course, so I really wanted one. But then when I got there, I wanted Caribbean colors. And I got there and they had one similar to Caribbean colors, but I was in the heart. I mean, I loved it. I loved it, I loved it. But I was like, oh, I might want to get something from Marigold Jam, or I don't know. So my friend Pam was, well, if you're thinking about it, can I get you this as a bridal shower gift? And I'm like, Pam, you know I'm not gonna say no. So she got me Blue Moon socks that rock in a light, what is it called? Lightweight. It's 405 yards. And I believe it's 100% superwash merino in the Azure Malachite. And I think it's pretty Caribbean colors because this is like the co this is not baby blue as it's showing. It's turquoise. It's very turquoise. And then you have the blue and the green, which I think the water is gonna look like, and then some purple. Reminds me of the carnival party ship that I'm gonna be on. So very pretty. And then I think we took a little bit of a break. No. Then we went to the Bird and Griffin. Took me like 10 minutes getting the booth. People don't have conversations in the middle of the booth and don't let anybody look at the yarn. Really? There was three women. They were just standing at the fingering weight, talking about the festival. They were friends, so they could have gone somewhere else. They weren't looking at yarn. They were talking about the yarn. They were talking about the festival. Get out of the booth. Like, one lady was like, they asked her a question, and she's like, no, I'm waiting to look at the yarn. Finally, I made it to the. I had one in eye. And I was like, if somebody grabs it while I'm standing in line to get to it, I'm gonna be so mad. How pretty is this? I want to cast on with this right away. This is gorgeous. It's the Bird and Griffin. I have a Bird and Griffin in my stash. That's the only one of the things I bought that I have one in my stash by this lace weight. It's a fingering weight, so it's in the Edos base, 100% superwash merino wool, 420 yards, in the experimental love child color. Oh, I love it. It is a teal aqua kind of color with this rusty orange. Oh, my colors. You put them two together and I'm like, so happy. This was definitely, I mean, the only thing I went for was socks that rock and that bat. The Miss Babs was impulse, this was impulse, next one was impulse. But oh, I went for something else. After that, we sat in the grass for a little bit and then I went and got a t-shirt. It is teal, it's not, I mean, it's a bluish green. And actually, this year it says 1973 and 2013 on the side, and it's the 40th and annual anniversary. And I'm pretty sure all the other ones, like I saw some people wearing older ones and they said which year it was. My last one, the 39th, doesn't say anything. Like, it's weird. But, anyways. And then my last purchase of the day. After we went to the podcaster meetup, we went to Hobbledy Hoy again, because I've been there three times that day. Took me a while to get in again. It was way more crowded this year. But they had a color called Galaxy that I really wanted in sock weight. They didn't have it in sock weight anymore. They had it in DK and worsted. And the yardage wasn't enough for what I would have done with it. So I looked around. Pam, she was gonna go in there with me, but it took me a while to get in. So she just sat down. I didn't see her sit down. So I grabbed like five skeins and looked around because I needed her help to decide. But she was nowhere to be found. So I had to make a decision myself. I don't even remember what I grabbed. One she had grabbed before that was a very Caribbean colors and it was kind of like island something. But I already had socks that rock, and I was like, I only need one. So this one looks very similar to Galaxy, kind of. It's Marigold Gin, and it's sock weight yarn, high twist MCN, 80% merino, 10% nylon, and 10% cashmere in the punkish colorway. So it's blacks with purples and pinks. Galaxy is blackish gray with shots of green, red, like all these pops of color. And that's why you should buy stuff when you see it. I don't even know if they had it in stock weight, honestly, because at that point I was just browsing and I saw it, the color, and maybe it wasn't even fingering weight. So then when I went back, I looked for the fingering, they didn't have it. Marigold Gin, it's my first Marigold Gin yarn, and it's so cool because into the world, I got to talk to Chris. I talked to Chris for a while, and then at Socks I Rock, it's Miss Babs. I talked to Miss Babs. Miss Babs grabbed my yarn because they all come with a tag, a thing that they hang it up with, and they pull them off. So while people were waiting in line, okay, and it has a little hook on the side, and they pull them off so your yarn doesn't get caught on other yarn. And Miss Babs cut mine off. I mean, I know Miss Babs touched this when she dyed it, but I was like, oh, and I got to talk to her for a little bit. And then I think her children are the ones that ran us out. Socks and Rock is sold by a store called Default, so I didn't talk to anybody there. The Verdant Griffin, I got a picture of, I don't know her name, but I'm assuming she's the Verdant Griffin person, because she is dressed in all Renaissance clothes. And Miracle Jen, Jenny Porter, the dyer, ran me out. So that was pretty neat. And that's all my enabling. I didn't write down my Netflix, but I know what I watched because I just watched it. I watched Django, which is with Leonardo DiCaprio and Jamie Foxx. Is that his name? I think so. It's a very long movie. It's 3 hours. I didn't expect it to be that long. It's a little slow. I thought it was going to be a funny movie. It's not funny at all. It's a drama. It's pretty depressing. It's about slavery. And Jamie Foxx gets saved by this guy, gets freed by the, he's a slave, and he gets freed by this German guy, which was hilarious to me because German, and he was funny. And they become bounty hunters. And then, but bounty hunters at that time, you didn't have to bring him alive, it was dead or alive. And then they go and hunt down Jamie Foxx's wife, and it's a Quentin Tarantino movie, there you go. If you like Quentin Tarantino movies, you'll like this one. There you go. That, like at the very beginning of the movie, 10 minutes in, I look at my fiance and I'm like, is this a Quentin Tarantino movie? And he's like, yeah. I was like, oh, that explains a lot. you can tell it's very much like his movies. I haven't had introductions in like over a month. So if you're new to the group or you haven't introduced yourself, or you haven't joined the group, I have a Ravelry group. It's called The Fearless Knitter. And thank you for the iTunes reviews and star ratings. I really appreciate them. They help keeping me going and motivated, because I know that people watch now, like after running into people, well, from person. And then it seems like I've been mentioned on podcasts. Like, not personally, but they say stuff that I know I said, kind of thing. I don't know. But the iTunes reviews, it just gives you a little boost. It's like, yes, I want to keep going. So I really appreciate you watching. And I hope to see you again next week. I hope you liked the Little Maryland review. Recap, there you go, that's what I was trying to think of. And I'm gonna have pictures that you just saw because they were at the beginning of this video. Alrighty, thanks for watching. Bye.
My brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals.